Assalamu alaikum. Good morning, everyone. Let us to start for how to interpret the EBG. ECG. ECG. What's ECG? The course today and tomorrow it will be interpretation, and alaikum salam, and it will be interactive between me and you. So, at any time, if anyone just he not understand or confusion, just raise your hand. Ask what you want, and will be interactive between me and you, inshallah. هعرفكم جاست بنفسي تعريف بسيط. أنا عماد عبد الواحد, consultant internist and emergency. وزي ما قدام إيه ال basic, I will go through basic ECG one by one. How to read the ECG from the ABC. So what is the ECG? What's ECG? Anyone can define what's the ECG? رسم القلب ده عبارة عن إيه؟
Electrocardiogram.
No, this electrocardiogram as a name. But what is the, what does it mean? يعني إيه الECG؟ بنشوفها إيه؟ الورقة اللي إحنا بنشوفها. What does إيه the ECG? What does it choose?
Electrical conduction.
Of what?
Of the heart.
Any other definition? What's ECG? What you said, you are right. ECG is an electrical conduction. It is a wave. الورقة اللي احنا بنشوفها waves. بنشوف waves. What this waves? The waves from the electrical event. There is some electrical event occur during the cardiac cycle. There is cardiac cycle. This cardiac cycle, which is considered up depolarization and repolarization, contraction and relaxation. This contraction and relaxation represent as a cardiac event. This cardiac event represented in a paper in form of waves. The waves اللي احنا بنشوفها اللي هي started from the B, BR, QRS, it is an cardiac event. So it is an electrical event during the cardiac cycle. So this is the definition of the ECG. Just a little basic information about the ECG. The first scientist who invent the machine, he was a physiologist, Dutch doctor. His name is William Insuven. الكلام ده سنة 1995. سنة 1895 أول واحد اخترع جهاز رسم قلب كان دكتور اسمه ويليام إنسوفن. ده كان دكتور بتاع فيسيولوجي. In 1924 he receives the Nobel Prize for this invention. يعني في سنة 1924 خد جائزة نوبل على الاختراع بتاعه ده. فأول واحد اخترع اللي هو رسم القلب المشين ويليام إنسوفن in 1995. And in 1924 he received his Nobel Prize for this invention. الECG ماشين وقت ما اخترعه لو هتشوف الصورة كانت تقريبا ممكن بتاخد ايه الجهاز about 2 متر by 2 متر. جهاز رسم القلب زمان حوالي 2 متر في 2 متر. ماشي, ده في اول اختراعه ده المشين. وكانوا بيستخدموا طبعا الارث اللي هو اللي احنا بنستخدمه بدل البلاك عبارة عن مثلا ايه زي اي شيء فيه مية. ده خط الارث الالكترودز نفسها لما كانت بتتوصل. فلو شفنا من الزمن من التمنميات للتطور اللي حصل في الاي سي جي, لكن دلوقتي الاي سي جي يو كان ريمبر من جهاز كان حجمه حوالي 2 متر في 2 متر لجهاز دلوقتي ممكن تشيله في ايدك. يو كان كاتش ات ان يور هاند. سم اوف ذا ماشين ناو يو كان كاري ان يور هاند. ذا موست الكترونيك وان اللي هي الماشين دلوقتي كلها which is fully computerized machine. And even you can use your computer as a machine. Just only some of the software connected to the computer and you can use the computer as a machine. So the updated machine, it is fully computerized. بس في نقطة مهمة في الماشين الفولي كمبيوترايزد. الفولي كمبيوترايزد machine, it is a software. It can read the ECG from APC. ممكن تكتب لك كل الاير ريبورت, فول ريبورت. But sometimes this report is wrong, totally wrong. You cannot depend on the diagnosis. يعني المشين it is written ST segment elevation. لكن in reality لما اجي اقراها ما فيش ST segment elevation. فلو ماشين ارى اس سي سيجمنت اليفيشن ماشي, وات ذا دايجنوزس, هي ويل دايجنوز ذس ام اي اند اتس نوت ذا ام اي. عشان كده في الكمبيوترايز ماشين يس يو كان ريد سم اوف ذا بيزك, ات ويل ريد ذا ريت صح, ات ويل ريد ذا اكس صح, ات ويل ريد ذا ديستانس او السبيس صح, but the diagnosis, final diagnosis, forget. Final diagnosis, it should be from your side. This is the only issues about the computerized machine. So computerized machine now, as you say, it is, you can carry this computerized machine in your hand. الpaper اللي احنا بنشوفه او قبل الpaper, how to connect the machine to the patient. How to connect the ECG machine to the patient. دلوقتي قدامي مريض والمريض ده انا عاوز اعمل له رسم قلب. How you connect the machine to the patient. Some instruction you should give it to the patient. This instruction when you give it to the patient, ask the patient to be fully relaxed. ريح نفسك خالص. Fully relaxation for the patient. You know some of the patient when he is coming to the in acute medicine or في ال ER or في ال emergency room, he's anxious. He has chest pain, he is sweaty, he has short of breath. Patient is anxious. Anxious patient and fully sweating, if you connect the electrodes, it will be loose. So ask the patient to be relaxed, fully relaxed. Put the patient in a supine position. Patient should be on supine. But some of the patient, if he is critically sick and he has short of breath, he cannot lie in supine. He can sit on a chair. And you can connect it and you can do the ECG while the patient is sitting on a chair. But the best to be patient fully supine. هينام على ظهره. Ask the patient to be fully relaxed. Take normal breathing. Yes. And if the patient has any electrical devices or some of the metal, لابس ساعة. بعض البنات في أي metal أو في gold. Remove the gold, remove the metal. If any cell phone, remove, take it away, or make it switch it off. Because all of this, it will affect the electricity which is conducted from the heart. يبقى بسأل المريض, fully relaxed, هنايمه على ظهره. بعد كده لو معاه أي حاجة معدل, هشيلها منه, الساعة, أي ذهب, أي شيء زي كده. طبعا الذهب الخفيف مثلا زي الرينج بسيبها. رينج, it can be. لكن لو في مثلا غوايش وفي حاجات زي كده, كل دي بإيه؟ بتتشال. وأسك the patient to إيه؟ fully relaxed. When the patient is fully relaxed and he is in supine position, some of the patient because of an anxiety, he doesn't know. Ask the patient not to cross his hand or cross the leg. فلازم both of the upper limbs fully extended, both of the lower limbs to be fully extended. فبعض المرضى اثناء التصوير يحرك نفسه, حط دراعه كده او هيحط رجل على رجل. It will mix the leads together. Once you give this instruction to the patient, الماشين الفولي كومبيوترايز ماشين هتصور وتعمل صوره على السكرين قدامي على الشاشه. When this screen, before you print the ECG, look to the screen. If there is any artifact or some of the errors, don't print the paper. This artifacts, what it's happened? Maybe the patient is moving or some of the electrodes becoming very loose and it is disconnected, reconnected again. Or the gel, when we bought the gel, it is not good quality gel. Refix it again and bottle it again. So this instruction, we should be give it to the patient before doing the ECG. If any artifact is happen, زي اللي احنا شايفينها كده. Sorry, the pointer طبعا مش هيشاور هنا. ودي عيب الشاشة دي هنا في ال... ده الجزء اللي هو هيبقى... خالد سوري هعوز... فيه كان زي قلم كده طويل بقدر بشاور به لان البوينتر هنا ما بيشتغلش على الشاشه, هيشتغل بس على الايه على البورد دلوقتي. يا ريت ماشي الله يكرمك ماشي اتس اوكي ما بعدين ما حد منهم يجي. فزي اللي احنا شايفينه قدامنا الحاجات المحبره بالاسود ده, this is artifact. During this artifact في some of the waves which is a BQRS, BQRS and then some artifact. If this artifact is happen, okay, reconnect the electrodes again. Ask the patient to relax, not to moving, and not to print, because this artifact, it will make some confusion. The ECG paper. All of the ECG paper, أنواع الأجهزة الموجودة, the machines for the ECG. still it's available اللي هو 1 channel و 3 channel والفولي كمبيوترايزد 1. الفولي كمبيوترايز 1 البيبر بتاع الفولي كمبيوترايز 1 اللي هي الـ A4 بيبر، الورقة اللي هي الـ A4 العادية، ده الفولي كمبيوترايز. لكن ستيل سم اوف ذا ماشين في 1 channel اللي احنا بنشوفها ليد 1 بعد كده ليد 2 ليد 3 اللي هو الشريط الطويل اللي احنا بنشوفه، وفي 3 channel انها بتصور 3 ليدز تحت بعض. ذا 3 channel ماشين، 3 channel it will be ليد 1 بعدها ليد 2 ليد 3 بعدين هيجي الـ AVR وبعدها الـ AVL وبعدها الـ AVF وبعد كده الـ V1 V2 V3 والـ A lateral leads. ده اسمها 3 channel. 3 channel means 3 leads under everyone. 3 channel very common موجودة دلوقتي في مصر. Still طبعا الـ 1 channel but خلاص يعني very old machine الـ 1 channel. But still some of the doctors are using الـ 1 channel. لكن المور ابديتد 1 اللي هو الفول بيبر اللي هو الايه البيبر اللي هي ال 4A اللي هي الفولي كمبيوترايز 1. All of the ECG paper it is a standard international standard متصممه الورقه in the four بيبقى عندي في مربع كبير big square inside the big square there is five small square 1 2 3 4 5 every small square is equal 1 millimeter. كلكم طبعا شفتوا ورقه رسم القلب في مربع كبير وجوه المربع الكبير في 5 small square big square every big square contains 5 small squares every small square is 1 millimeter. ال 1 millimeter how a equals in second Raise your voice. No, 1 millimeter. How to transfer in 1 millimeter? 2 seconds. 4 من 100 which is 0.04 second. So, 1 millimeter equal 0.4 seconds. It is very important when we have a distance or an interval. It will come later on. How to calculate the distance or the interval of the ECG, either by millimeter or by second. And it is better to make it both, by millimeter and by second. It's very easier. One millimeter is equal 0.04 second. From where this 0.04 second comes? A very common question in master cardiology or MD cardiology. Somebody knows? الأربعة من مية دي جت ازاي؟ اتحسبت ازاي؟ ليه ما نقولش مثلا خمسة من مية؟ ليه ما نقولش ايه؟ 10 من مية؟ why only for ايه 0.4؟ What is not 0.5؟ From where this comes؟ الأربعة من مية. عاوزين نصحصح شوية ها؟ الديوريشن اوف كارديك سايكل ولا الديوريشن اوف وات؟ ها؟ بتقول صح بس عايز تجمع. ها
هي جزء منها ممكن نقفل البولاريزيشن.
طيب
ال 1 مينت بتتقسم يعني الجهاز بيرسم يعني 300 مربع ده الدقيقه
بيرسم 300 مربع في الدقيقه. ها برضو كلامك قريب صح. طيب الجهاز وهو ماشي الجهاز اللي هو بيعمل الويفز when he is making the waves الويفز up and down there is the speed of the machine there is a needle. This needle, when it makes this wave up and down, there is a speed. And this international in all of the machine, whether it is 1 channel or 3 or full 1, this speed is 25 millimeter per second. So the speed of the machine, what is the speed of the machine? الإبرة اللي بتحبر اللي بتدينا الويفز, it is ماشية بسرعة 25 millimeter per second. يبقى سرعة الجهاز سرعة الجهاز ماشية بسرعة 25 ملي بتعمل 25 ملي في الثانية الواحدة بير سكند تمام 25 ملي في الثانية ال 25 ملي في الثانية يبقى احنا لو هقول ال 1 مليمتر يساوي قد ايه 25 ملي في الثانية الواحدة لو انا عاوز اشوف بقى ال 1 ملي في قد ايه من الثانيه؟ يبقى بقسم 1 على 25 تدينا 0.04، صح ولا لا؟ Very common question in master cardiology and MED. How you know 1 millimeter equal 0.4? So, because the speed of the machine is 25 milli per second. طب again, all of the paper for the ECG, the big square is 5 small square. Every small square is 1 millimeter, which is 0.4. This is the horizontal one. So horizontal, this is big square, 5 small. And then the in vertical one. The vertical one, this is a big square. Again, the vertical one, 5 small square. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Sorry. But the vertical one, which is 5 millimeter. In 5 millimeter in volt, which is equal half millivolt. So this some of the basic knowledge you should know. The every big square horizontal is 5 small square. Every small square 1 millimeter, which is equal in second 0.04 second. This horizontal. What about the vertical? The vertical big square, again, it is 5 millimeter. But the 5 millimeter as a volt, which is equal half millivolt. Okay? This half millivolt, it is very important to look in the ECG. What's called calibration line or calibration signal. What is calibration line or calibration signal? Calibration line, هنتلاقيه في الفرخ الكبير أو الثري شانل أو whatever في نهاية الفرخ أو في بداية الفرخ. بيبقى رسم لي حاجة line كده. This calibration line which is equal to big square vertical. To big square vertical. Either in the beginning of the page or at the end of the page. To big square. This one square and this one square. To big square. How much is a big square? Two big square. So the two big square, the one only 5 millimeter. So the 10, it will be 10 millimeter. The one small square, one big square, which is half millimeter. So it will equal here 1 millivolt. This is calibration line. What does it indicate? ليه بنعرفه أو what is its importance? في حاجات ثابتة في كل الماشين. احنا قلنا البيبر دي ستاندردايزد انترناشونال ان متصممه الايه البيج سكوير في خمسه صغيرين كل واحد مربع صغير بواحد ملي ده في الايه بالنسبه بالعرض بالطول ان كل واحد ملي خمسه بتمثل بقى ده ايه 1.5 فولت الكاليبريشن لاين عباره عن مربعين كبار بس بالايه بالطول ده متصمم في كل الاجهزه احيانا لحاجات معينه الكاليبريشن لاين ده عن طريق زرار معين في ايه في الجهاز نغيره خليه يطول بدل ما هو مربعين كبار it will be 3 big square او نخليه 1 ايه big square فبالتالي الكاليبريشن لاين اتغير عشان كده هنيجي بعد كده ما نيجي نشوف حاجه اسمها لو فولتج اي سي جي او هاي فولتج اي سي جي اللو والهاي دي جايه منين؟ من الكاليبريشن لاين هنيجي نعرفها فيما بعد ايه فدي كلها بيزك ايه be aware منها. So the ECG paper, all of the ECG paper, it is standard, international, in which this is a big square. This is a big square. Inside the big square, 5 small square. Every small square, which is equal 1 millimeter, which is 0.4 second. From with the upper file, because the speed of the machine, 25 millimeter per second. As in front of you, one small square, 0.04, one larger square, 0.2 second. This is the calibration line. Calibration line, which is two big square, vertical. Two big square, vertical. This is what's called calibration line. So the calibration line, which is two big square. This is one big square and the second big square. This is the calibration line. It will choose later on. So the paper is a special paper the speed of the paper 25 per second. So every 1 millimole square, it will be equal 0.4 second. هنقسم 1 على 25. الـ ECG leads. How to know the ECG leads? And how to connect the ECG leads? We have 6 limb leads with 6 chest leads. Leads for the ECG. For the limb leads, for chest leads. For the limb, it is 6. In the machine, it is 6. How many leads for the limb leads في المشين؟ ها؟ 3؟ حد يزود؟ حد ينقص؟ ها؟ الليمب ليدز في الجهاز قد ايه؟ كام واحدة؟ 4. 4. متأكد؟
هو الأسود يعني مش هيتحسب ولا
لأ؟ طبعًا هيتحسب. 4. So the limb leads is only in the machine is 4. It's not 6. Okay؟ طب ليه عم بنخليهم 6 ليه؟ سلام يا دكتور. So for the leads, limb leads كم واحدة؟ 6. Reality for the machine it is only 4. Okay. الشيست leads كم leads؟ 6. Started from V1 to V6. لكن limb leads only 4. And lead 1 و2 و3. بس الـ lead 1 و 2 و 3 it is known by focal or bipolar leads. What means bipolar? Lead 1 and 2 and 3 it is bipolar leads. Bipolar leads, what does it mean? It makes the electrical difference between two areas. So lead 1 it will take the electrical difference between a right arm and the right a left arm, or between a right shoulder or left shoulder. This is lead 1. هنشوفها صور. Lead 2 between a right shoulder and the left foot. This is lead 2. Okay. What about lead 3? Left shoulder and the left foot. This is bipolar leads. But the other 3 leads اللي هي يبقى lead 1 و2 و3 ده بنسميها ايه؟ bipolar leads. What means bipolar leads? It makes electrical difference between two areas. 1, 2, 3. What about the other 3 leads, which is AVR, AVL, AVF? The other 3 leads is unipolar. Unipolar means it takes the electricity from only one area. The abbreviation of AVR, augmented vector of right arm. AVL, augmented vector of left arm. AVF, augmented vector of left foot. What about a right foot? اللي هي بتبقى السوداء. This is an earth, خط أرضي. اللي احنا شفنا الرسمة الأولانية كانوا بيحطوا رجل الايه؟ اليمين دي اللي هي فين؟ في مية. So the colors هنشوفها بعد كده في الاس جي. So the limb leads 6. In reality for the machine it's only 4. But this 4 makes us ايه؟ 3 bipolar 1 و 2 3 و others which is unipolar AVR, L and F. For the chest leads, all chest leads unipolar. Because it takes electricity from only one area, started from V1 up to V6. This is the limb chest leads. It's very important when we bought the machine, and we'll ask the patient to make relax, and we'll connect the bats or electrodes. When you connect the bats, after, عشان بس الزمن كان جاي متأخر, ask the patient to be relaxed, put the patient on supine position, take or metal or any gold from the patient, ask the patient to take normal breath and start to connect the leads or electrodes. Both the leads for, احنا عندنا في الاجهزة القديمة, all of the old machine still making a color. Red, yellow, green, black. All of the modern machine, كل اللي هو full computerized, there is no color. But on the electrodes, على الميتال أو على الالكترودز, it is written. This is AVR. This is AVL. This is lead one. This is lead two. It is written. عشان ما يحصلش confusion بعد the nursing stuff. But from our side, we should know the machine إزاي بتشتغل. لأني how to know the ECG when you read it. There is some artifact or some error. Some error أو بيحصل فيه because one of the lead is connected wrongly. ازاي ان احنا نقراها ونعرفها من الايه بعد كده من الاي سي جي مهمه جدا وبتيجي تريكس طبعا كتير في الامتحانات. لونج او رونج ليدز. رونج ليدز معناها اتوصلت غلط. بدل ما حطت في واحد حطت في اربعة. بتحصل طبعا بتحصل كتير على فكره. طيب يبقى لازم الاناتوميكال بوزيشن بتاع الليدز خاصه الشيست ليدز لازم نعرفها. الاناتوميكال بوزيشن للشيست ليدز وي شود نو. في 1 فورس انتركوستال سبيس جاست رايت تو ذا ستيرنم. This is V1. So anatomical place for V1, fourth intercostal space, just right to the sternum. V2, the same. Fourth intercostal space, just left to the sternum. نفسها بالضبط. واحدة right, واحدة left. ده V2. V3, midway between V2 and A4. 4, 5, 6. 4 and 5 and 6. All in the fifth intercostal space. يبقى 4 و5 و6 all in the fifth intercostal space. But وين؟ ال 4 V4 mid clavicular line. 5 anterior axillary line. 6 mid axillary line. هقولهم تاني؟ هنشوفهم طبعا على رسمه وتبقى واضحه. يبقى الشيست ليدز very important to know the anatomical position. V1 fourth intercostal just right to the sternum. 2 fourth intercostal just left to the sternum. 3 midway between 2 and 4. 4, 5, 6 all in the fifth intercostal space. 4 mid clavicular. 5 anterior axillary. 6 mid axillary line. Okay? This anatomical position. Let us see on the screen. So we have 12 leads. 6 for limb and 6 for chest. Limb leads, we have 3 bipolars. اللي هي قلنا بتاخد electrical difference between two area 1 and 2 and 3 and the other unipolar AVR L F. For this leads, this is a bipolar leads. Bipolar leads connected between a red and yellow lead 1. Okay? Between a red and the green, this is lead 2. Between a yellow and the green, lead 3. Okay? فديت واضحة بالنسبة للايه؟ للبايبولار ليدز. What about unipolar؟ الريد AV R، اليلو AV L، الايه؟ الجرين AV F، والسودا اللي هي الايه؟ الرايت ارث 1. This is a chest leads. زي ما باين قدامنا في الشيست ليدز. This is V1 fourth intercostal space. 2 قصادها على طول. 3 midway, 4 and 5 and 6 all in the 5th intercostal space. دي الرسمة دي هتوضح أكتر. This is the V1. Still again الكالر ديت موجودة في الماشينز القديمة اللي هي ال 1 channel و 3 channel. هنشوفها بنفس الألوان دي. الليمب ليدز عندنا الأربع ألوان اللي هو الأحمر والأصفر الأخضر الأسود. والشيست ليدز بنفس الألوان دي. تبدأ من الأحمر الأصفر الأخضر بعد كده البراون والبلاك والبيربل 1. لكن النيو ماشين ما فيش فيها الوان بط لكن اللودز الالكترودز it is written this is V1 this is AVR and so on. This is the 4, 5, 6 all in the 5th intercostal space. البراون 1 mid clavicular. البلاك anterior axillary. البيربل in the mid axillary line. Again, anatomical position للايه؟ للـ V1, as I said. As you look. Sorry. This is the new electrodes, the fully computerized machine. As you look, there is no color. In new machines, computerized machines, there is no colors. But in the bed itself, it is written here V1, V2, V3, and so on. It is written on the bed. ما فيش colors. من الصورة ديت what you know أو there is some difference What difference? Can you pick up what is the difference? L? V, I, ولا على دي؟ V3, R. V4, R. في حاجة زي كده؟ ده البوستير؟ لا طبعا. So what is V3R or V4R? What is this? في الماشين ما فيش فيها كده، هم ستة بس الليمب ليدز، الشيست ليدز اونلي 6. ما فيش بقى سبعة وثمانية. Right ECG. Very good. ف what is right ECG؟ هنشوف ده بعد كده إن شاء الله بكرة لما نتكلم على الـ MI when we speak about the NI and we have a inferior myocardial infarction. When you have selected MI like the inferior myocardial infarction, we should do what's called right chest leads. What is right chest leads? The right chest leads, the chest leads كلها اللي احنا بنحطها من started from V1 to V6. Instead of make it on the left side, we make it on the right side. ده في حالات معينة زي الـ inferior MI ومهمة جدا جدا وقت ما نتكلم بكرة إن شاء الله on the inferior MI why we make right chest leads. It's very very important in management and the diagnosis. So in some selected case of MI like inferior MI, I read the inferior MI and I should put all of the leads instead on the left side, I will shift it to the right side. V1 it will be here, V2 it will be here. And then 3, 4, 5 like this. This is what's called right chest leads. Okay. The right chest leads. In some selected patient or some selected diagnosis, we should do what's called right chest leads. And in some selected patient, we should do what's called posterior chest leads. قبل ما نشوف الصورة حد عارف نعملها أو بنعملها ليه؟ Why we make posterior chest leads? In posterior MI, how you suspect posterior MI?
There is a reflection in the anterior leads. You suspect that there is a ST elevation, so they appear ST retraction.
Okay.
Hmm.
Yes, you are talking correctly. Yes, very very good, excellent. But still, I was just جمعها شوي. In some selected patient, when we read the ECG, we diagnose this patient posterior myocardial infarction. How to confirm it is posterior myocardial infarction? بعد ما بقرا الـ ECG العادية، أنا موصل إيه؟ chest leads كلها V1, V2, V3. In V1 and V2, what we will see in V1? ST segment depression with tall R. Once I saw ST segment depression in V1 and 2 with tall R, I suspect posterior MI. In that case, how to confirm? I will take V1 and the V2 and instead here in the right, I will put it posteriorly on the back because this V1 and the 2, it will lock to the posterior wall as a mirror image. كأنك واقف قدام مراية. فعشان أصلح الصورة هاخد I will take V1 and the V2. I will put it back. V1 and the V2, it will be below the angle of the scapula. And the V1, it will be lateral. V3, it will be medial. الصورة ديت هتبين لنا البوستيرور how to make. Okay? So in posterior MI, I will do what's called posterior chest leads. In inferior MI, I will do what's called right chest leads. طيب لما نجي لها يبقى في توضيح أكثر إن شاء الله. الأناتوميكال position for ischemia and MI. It's very important to know the place. Mainly from the chest leads. For ischemia and the MI, mainly we are looking to ST segment and the T wave. If there is a change in the ST, what is change in this ST? Either depression or elevation. Normally the ST it will be isoelectric. So the changes of ischemia and the MI, how to make it? Numination. We are saying septal MI. What this means by septal MI? Where is the change in the ECG? In the septal MI, V1, V2, V1 and V2, very good. So if there is a change in the ST, depression or elevation, or T wave inversion in V1 and V2, this mainly septal part. So septal MI, it changes in ST or the T wave, mainly in V1 and 2. So the first one, septal MI or septal change if there is a change in V1 and V2. If there is a change in V3 and V4, this is the anterior one, V3 and V4, it will be anterior. What about if there is a change started from V1 to V4? What we call it? Anteroposterior. So V1 and 2, only septal. 3 and 4, anterior. If it takes started from V1 until V4, it will be anteroseptal. Okay? So the second one is the anterior one, which it take a change only in 3 and 4. If the change is taken in the, which is the lateral one, lead one, and AVL, and the 5 and 6, this part with what's called lateral ischemia or lateral MI. So changes in lead 1 and AVL with 5 and 6, this is what's called lateral. If we'll make it a little bit complicated, we can see only lateral leads started from V4 and 5 and 6. A high lateral, which is take 1 and AVL, if we be more specific. So if the changes is take 4, 5, 6 only without 1 and AVL, what we call this lateral. If it will take 4, 5, and 6, and 1 and AVL, high lateral. Okay? But if you say that lateral, it is correct. The last one, if the changes happen in 2 and 3 and AVF. 2, 3 and AVF, what we call it? Inferior. It changes or inferior ischemia or inferior MI. So this is the last part, which is the inferior part. 2 and 3 and AVF. AVR. The AVR, as you look in front of you, this is the only leads in the ECG in which all the waves are inverted. The only leads on the ECG, normal, physiological, all of the waves inverted down. So the B wave, as you say, this is the B wave down. Then the QRS down. Then the T wave down. This is normal. So all the waves in the AVR are inverted. P, QRS, and T. What about if it is up? What diagnosis?
ECG
wrong. Wrong ECG, very good. What else?
Dextrocardia,
very good. When we have the AVR, in the AVR, instead all of the waves are down, it becomes a positive. We have two options. Either it is wrong leads or dextrocardia. Okay? Tfaddali. Dextrocardia. El AVR, el all of the waves in the AVR, this is the AVR. AVR. Normally, physiological, all of the waves in the AVR, negative deflection. كلها بصل تحت. This is the B wave, this is the QRS, and this is the T wave. This is normal. What about if the AVR, شفناها شكل كده. كلها بصل فوق. Two options, wrong leads or dextrocardia. Okay. ECG interval. Very important for the ECG interval to know the distance. Normal, physiological, we have three intervals in the ECG. Three intervals in the ECG. The first interval is BR interval. Second interval, which is QRS. The third interval, which is QT interval. All of this interval, we should know the duration of each interval. هتحتاج, we should keep. How to keep it? By practice. But just by daily practice, we should know the figures and the numbers of each interval. We should know. This is the normal. If it is abnormal, either increase or decrease, it is abnormal. For the increase or decrease, there is causes for that. For about the BR, this is the BR interval, which started from the beginning of the B wave until the end of the B wave or the start of the Q or the start of the R. So from the beginning of the B till the beginning of the R, this is what's called BR interval. So this is the first interval. BR interval, how much it's long? The duration of the BR. هاد عارف؟ How much?
Two large boxes?
Two large? Oh, so much. One large box? Up to one large. Up to one, which is five. Up to?
No, it's one.
One box. Only one box. Not more than one box. So the PR interval, 3 to 5 millimeter. يعني هتبقى من ثلاث مربعات صغيرين لخمس مربعات صغيرين. So maximum one large box, because the large box is 5 millimeter. So normally PR interval from 3 to 5 millimeter. How much per second? I will write here. This is the number for the first number. Second number. Only one here. Only a doctor can. How much? كم؟ 12% ها؟ ال 2 من 10 very good. So the first one will multiply 0.04 by 3. It will be 0.12. Okay? And the second one will multiply 0.04 by 5. It will be 0.2. Okay? So by second, from 0.12 to 0.2. This by second. By small square, from 3 to 5 small square. What about the QRS? Duration of QRS? One small box? Up to? Two and a half, three. Yeah, but usually up to 2.5. Yeah. For QRS as a duration, for the millimeter, it will be 2.5 millimeter. مربعين ونص صغيرين. Which is equal in second, less than or equal 0.10 second. Okay, this is the QRS. So the duration of the QRS 2.5. أقل من مربعين ونص صغيرين. اللي هتساوي 0.10 second. What about the QT? QT interval 0.44 second. How much square? 2.5 large square. Sorry. عشان نسهلها في الحفظ وتبقى سهلة في الحفظ. ال QRS مربعين ونص صغيرين. ال QT مربعين ونص كبار. خلاص سهلة. بس خلاص طالما قلنا مربعات نقدر نحول للسكن. So for the QRS less than 2.5 small square. ال QT less than 2.5 big square. Okay. How much a second? Less than 0.10 second. Less than 0.44 second. طب نعرف ده ليه؟ Why what's the importance of that? Arrhythmia is very good. What else?
Heart block.
Very good. Excellent. Huh? Why you know this? It is very important diagnosis. Yes. That's why the interval, one of the interpretation of the ECG, we should look to the interval and you calculate the interval to know the duration. It's normal. It's okay. Well and good, it's normal. But if the duration is less, we call it this what? Short BR. If the BR is more than 0.2, we'll call it this prolonged PR. For the short BR or small PR, there is causes. For the prolonged one, there is causes. We should know like that, okay? So the three interval, the BR interval started from the beginning of the T until the R. The second one, which is yellow, QRS, this is the duration. The last one started from the beginning of the Q until the end of the T, which is QT interval. QT interval, مربعات كبيرة. BR, مربعات صغيرة. QRS, مربعات صغيرة. So again, it's very little bit easier. QRS, small squares. QT interval, big squares. تفضل.
G point.
G point. Very good. Excellent questions. نرجع عليها. دكتور لاحظ حاجة هنا مكتوبة what's called here is J point. دي what is J point؟ خلينا نشوفها and what's its importance. B wave, what represented B wave? Atrial contraction or atrial depolarization. Then Q R S, what represent ventricular depolarization or contraction? طب Q R S it will end by the Q R S. Okay. This what's called the J wave. The J wave is the junction. It is a junction, نقطة اتصال. Junction, point of connection. What is J point as a definition? It is a point of connection between the end of the S and the start of the ST. So this is a point. This is ST. This is the end of the S and the start of the ST. This is a point. So this point is known as J point. Okay, so the J point, it is a junction or the connection point of connection, end of the S with the start of the ST. In some of patients, this J point is raised. بتعلى. Okay, when the J point is raised, this is normal physiology, which is known as early repolarization. Because the QRS, physiologically, this is representing ventricular depolarization, ventricular contraction. It started from the ST and the T, this means ventricular repolarization. So, بداية repolarization, relaxation of the ventricle, starts at the J point. Sometimes this J point is raised, what is called early repolarization. Early repolarization, Norman phenomenon. بتحصل احيانا لخبطه مع الاس تي سيجمنت اليفيشن. عشان كده من ضمن الحاجات اللي تعمل اس تي سيجمنت اليفيشن الايرلي ريبولاريزيشن. But the early repolarization normal phenomenon. الام اي this is pathology. خلاص يا دكتور ولا ها مين اللي كان سأل على شيء؟ It's okay. Conduction pathways. Normal conduction pathways. As you look the normal conduction pathways, which is this is the started of the electricity, our electricity, contraction and relaxation. It started from the SA node. This is our main pacemaker. Where our main pacemaker, the SA node, in the right atrium. This is the AA SA node. SA node in the right atrium, just near to the severe vena cava. This is the anatomical position of SA node. And this is our main pacemaker. So the charge or the impulse started from the SA node down to the AV node and from the AV node to the bundle of Hertz. Bundle of Hertz في interventricular septum. في the upper third of the upper third of the interventricular septum, the bundle of Hertz bifurcates to two branch, one to the left ventricle, one to the right ventricle. The left ventricle this branch, it is divided another two branches. اللي هو anterior fascicle والposterior fascicle. All the branches بعد كده التانية ديت بتنتهي بسمول fibers which is known as Purkinje fibers. So normal conduction pathways started from the SA node, right atrium, to the AV node, bundle of His, bifurcate one to the left and one to the right. To the left, only two fascicle, anterior fascicle, posterior fascicle, and to the right only one branch, all endish by Purkinje fibers. What is the importance of that? Well, you know, conduction block. Inshallah, bukra, ما يجي ناخد the conduction block بدون ما نعرف ديت, all the conduction block. Because if the electricity is interrupted here, it will be a block. If it will be cutted here or interrupted, it will be a block, a degree of block. When we have the first degree, second degree, third degree, we should know this conduction pathways. Through the conduction pathway, we can pick up the conduction defects or conduction block. هنعرفها بكرة إن شاء الله. So this is the normal conduction pathways started from the SA node to the AV node, bundle of Hertz, bundle branch, Purkinje fiber. pacemakers of the heart. What is, if the question like that, what our main pacemaker of the heart? Main pacemaker?
SA
node. How much it figures? How much it gives the impulse? How much our heart rate? A normal heart rate, how much? 60 up to? 60 to 90, لو في بعض textbook. So the SA nodes, it gives an impulse or discharge. How much? From 60 up to 100. This is a normal heart rate. What happens if the SA node is not working, is damaged, becomes fibrosed? What will happen? إلا يطلع فوكس ها الاتريوم منين من الاتريوم الاتريوم نفسه ولا حاجة في الاتريوم ها الافي نود سو المين وان اس اي نود الفاير بتاعتها او الامبرس بتاعتها from 60 up to 100 if the اس اي نود is not working or damaged still we are alive what is replacing what is the backup our backup it will be the AV node. So the SA node, this is the main pacemaker. The backup is the AV node. But our heart, if the AV node is working, it will become the main pacemaker. They will have bradycardia. Heart rate, it will be from 40 to 60. 40 to 60. For anyone when we have heart rate below 60, maybe it started from the AV node, not from the SA node. You get my point? So when we have bradycardia, whatever the reason, maybe the SA node, not the SA node is working, the AV node is working, it takes the backup. So when we have firing rate or the heart rate from 40 up to 60, whose is work? The AV node, not the SA node. Okay? Because there is block, there is degree of block, or the SA node is not working. If it become a little bit complicated, both are not working. SA node is not working, AV node is not working. What will happen? We have heart block, but still we are alive, we can alive or not. Purkinje fibers. لأ Purkinje fibers صعب أوي ما نجيش. لكن هي الventricular cells. So if both are not working, SA node is not working and the AV node is not working, still من يعني ربنا سبحانه وتعالى مدينا back up from the ventricular cells itself. Ventricular self still it can make as a pacemaker, but giving impulse and the firing from 20 to 40. هيبقى severe bradycardia. فلو شفنا severe bradycardia أقل من 40, this is from ventricular cells. Means the SA node is not working, AV node is not working, or there is severe degree of block. So in the impulse is not coming down. So the ventricular cells is making up as a backup for both SA node and AV node. So this is a pacemaker. The pacemaker still, the SA node, اللي هي firing rate بتاعها من 60 up to 100. If still is not working, the backup is from the AV node, 40 to 60. Both are not working, the ventricular cells will back up from 20 to 40. ده بالنسبة للـ pacemaker. دي نقط مهمة يعني تعرفوها لأن أحيانا طبعا في الامتحانات أو في حاجة كمان. Normal ECG. عند ديت وهناخد بالجابست 5 minutes عاوزين نكمل النورمال اي سي جي هاو تو ريد ذا اي سي جي من نورمال الاي سي جي ان فرونت اوف اس ذيس از نورمال اي سي جي واي وي سيد ذيس از نورمال اي سي جي ذير از كرايتيريا فور ذات او ماشي اوكي طبعا ديت فيري جود يعني طبعا لاحظتها كنت يعني هقولها لكم ده الكاليبريشن لاين كاليبريشن لاين اللي انا قلته في اول المحاضره اللي هو الايه تو بيج سكوير الفيرتيكال هاي لا اما في بدايه الصفحه او في نهايه الصفحه at the beginning or at the end this is what's called the calibration once I saw calibration lines it is two big squares means there is no any voltage abnormality فالويفز اللي متحركه فوق وتحت ديت صح لان الستاندرد بتاع all of the machine معمول ان الكاليبريشن لاين all the standard to be two big square vertical لو تلاقيت الستاندرد ده 3 بيج سكوير ده هاي فولتج لازم اظبط الماشين مره ثانيه واعمل الاي سي جي مره ثانيه بعد احيانا ممكن حد يلعب في بعض الزراير وخاصه الالكترونيك يخليها اونلي 1 بيج سكوير هيبقى لو فولتج لو قلت له فولتج وحسبت ان المريض ده هايبوثيرميك او 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 هكذا هيبقى الدايجنوز بتاعي رونج. يبقى فيري امبورتنت اول حاجه ابص عليها في الاي سي جي الكالبريشن لاين تو بيج سكوير. خلاص كل الويفز دي صح خلاص. اتس فيري فيري امبورتنت طبعا اند فيري تريكي. احيانا بننساها كتير وممكن نقع فيها في الامتحانات او ريال لايف ان احنا لازم ابص على الكالبريشن لاين اما في بدايه او في الايه في النهايه. Once it is too big square, so all of the wells as a voltage, دي كلها صح. Why we said this is normal ECG? Normal ECG, عندي 10 criteria أو 10 point I should make a comment. وده بداية إزاي to interpret the ECG. يبقى هيكون عندي 10 point. هكتب ال 10 point وهنبتدي فيهم بعد كده. لو حابين ناخد rest مجرد دقيقتين أو شيء. As you like. عاوزين نكمل زي ما انتوا حابين. So to interpret the ECG, وانا ما باجي اكتب ريبورت او هبعت ريبورت للزميل على الاي سي جي. احيانا بعض الزملاء حتى كارديولوجيست هو سطر. ماشي هو كتب نورمال اي سي جي. هل هو كتبت it's normal ECG I'm right? I'm totally wrong. فلما تيجي تبعت لحد وخاصة دكاترة الانستيزيا او لدكتور مش في نفس التخصص بتاعك او it's not in the same subject. Don't write this is normal ECG. Just normal ECG وخلاص وابعت. Totally wrong. اكتب comment. في النهاية اكتب normal ECG. هقول له البي ويف normal. هقول له البي ار normal. هقول له كذا 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 normal. لكن just ان ببعتها له normal ECG ما استفدش حاجة. وطبعا ممكن يكون في الECG سوري بلاوي. وما تبقاش normal. ماشي؟ فأعمل comment. الكومنت ده لو خدناها يعني in chronological way very simple وvery easy. يعني خدناها بس just very simple. هاخدها one point by one point. First one هشوف الريت ويبقى لازما بكتب للدكتور الهارت ريت كذا. طبعا قلنا الكمبيوترايز ماشين هتكتب هيدي لي ريبورت فوق مكتوب خلاص
ماشي.
بس نعم
اول حاجه بص على الاي في عشان ممكن
اعمل سي جي. ما هنيجي للنقط فيها كلها. سو الهارت ريت لازما احسب الهارت ريت. نمبر 2 هشوف الريزم الريزم بتاع الاي سي جي. نمبر 3 الكارديك اكسس. نمبر 4 البي ويف. 5 البي ار انترفال. نمبر 6 الكيو ار اس ديوريشن والشكل بتاعها. نمبر 7 هناخدها واحده واحده الاس تي سيجمنت. بعد كده 8 التي ويف. نمبر 9 الكيو تي انترفال. نمبر 10 additional waves. additional waves لو مشينا بنفس الايه الكرونولوجيكال واي او ناس ذا سيم سيكونس اي ويل نوت ميس اني ماينور بوينت في الاي سي جي. مشيها وان ستيب باي ايه باي ستيب. ات ذا اند ات از نورمال ات از اب نورمال وات اب نورماليتي وي كان ايه وي كان سي.